Hello, everyone. You know why I am wearing like this? You know why I put my jacket there? You know why I am using this watch? You know? I tell you, because in life, everything is persuasion. That's why marketing is so important, not only for business, but I would say for our daily lives. But let's take the case of business. If you go to a shop, you buy products. They are not there just because someone thought, but probably because the companies have studied the market, have tried to understand consumers, have established their targets, have developed a value proposition, which hopefully is distinctive and attractive to the customers, and then they have developed what we call a marketing mix approach. That is product, price, promotion, distributions, and so forth. The point is that on the shelves, we don't find products like this. In fact, products have brands, and brands have meanings in our mind. Not only, in fact, in our mind, but also in our heart. This means that brands have both a functional and an emotional side. I would like to use some few minutes to talk about the emotional side of brands. And my question is, how do brands try to seduce you every day? I would like to suggest you three ways. Firstly, because emotional brands offer you flowers. If you prefer a more technical way of saying this, I would say brands use a symbolic identity. You want to see some examples? This one. They sell technology, but they are not called hardware, they are not called digital, they are not called technology. The name is Apple. The relation between Apple and computers or other gadgets is zero. But Apple is an emotional name, and the symbol is emotional. Everything says that this is an emotional brand, as well as this. The bird feeding small birds in a nest. This is a fantastic emotional brand. Very interesting because the signature of the brand has both sides. Good food is functional. Good life is emotional. This, I don't need to put the name of the brand, you know, but of course it is an emotional brand. Of course, they sell emotion. Rabbit, fantastic. Fantastic, this is emotion, as well as this, not only in consumer goods, but let's just take an example of a more business-to-business good, Novagres. Novagres is a company located south of Porto, around Aveiro. They sell tiles. In the past, they use the name Novagres, the corporate name. Now they use love to sell ties. If I omit the last part, probably you think that they were selling condoms. But no, no, they are selling ceramic tiles, in fact. Worldwide Foundation, fantastic, to save the species. What animal did they choose? A panda. Let's just imagine that they choose a scorpion. People say, well, let's kill the animal. Fantastic. But no, it's a panda. Everyone likes a panda. This is emotion. This is not direct to our minds. It's direct to our hearts. Banco Alimentar, too. People working together. An emotional appeal, just the sign, just the brand, just the logo. Lipor deals with rubbish. They don't put rubbish. They put heart, they put an art. Green, of course, because this is good for the environment. So all of these examples show us that even with the brand itself, the name, the logo, the slogan, and so forth, it's possible to induce an emotional appeal. But it's more than that. Companies also communicate with passion. In a technical way, I would say that they use an emotional marketing communication strategy. That's the way I teach to my students. But in fact, they talk with passion, such as this Coca-Cola talk with passion. They don't say it's good. They created the figure of Santa Claus. In fact, they didn't create the Santa Claus. Santa Claus is Saint Nicholas, but they create that figure. A fat guy, long white beard, dressed in red. I would prefer if it was blue and white, but no. It's red, of course. Coca-Cola is red. And this is the grandfather everyone would like to have. They are inducing affection. They are inducing emotion, as well as Nespresso with George Clooney. Most people say George Clooney is very good for the female segment. That's true. And it's good for the male segment, because we men also would like to be like George Clooney. So with one guy, they captured both segments. Fantastic. Calvin Klein. They are not saying that this can be washed in washing machine, color, things like that. No, no one buys Calvin Klein because of that emotional appeal. As well as, again, Apple. This is a famous campaign conducted, well, a long time ago. Steve Jobs was a young guy by that time. Think different. They didn't promote computers. They didn't promote motherboards. They didn't promote memories. They just say, think different, be different. Because the guys who think different are the guys who buy Apple. That's why we love. We don't like, we love Apple, which is, in fact, different. Let us take an example of Portugal. 90 years ago, Ramos Pinto, they produced these fantastic adverts. They don't say that wine is good. They don't say that wine is old. They don't promote vintage. They just say, the port wine Ramos Pinto is a temptation. I think so. It is a temptation with these ladies, young ladies there. Even if I'm selling drugs, there are many different ways. They just say that they are relieving the pain, but in an emotional way. Of course, this induces loyalty. These are magnetic brands. It's not only a matter of relieving pain. It's a matter of the heart liking that. The third way is offering a fantastic life to the customers. Of course, let us take the real technical name, using experiential marketing. That's what most brands are doing. And they offer lots of experience. Most of them are related with aesthetic experience, which has to do with design. Most people here think that this is a watch. No. What you are seeing here is not a watch. It's a bracelet. I'm not using this for watch. This is my bracelet, which of course tells me the time, because my watch is here. Okay. I don't need this. You don't need this. This is a bracelet. You need to change bracelet. Well, I think that with black, red is good. Is it? Okay. It has to do with TEDx. Well, I think that's good. This is a bracelet. This has to do with fashion, not with watches and the accuracy of watches. This is also a fantastic example of a good experience. Because this is not a car. Most people think that a smart is a car. No, it is not a car. It is half a car. Which costs the same as a full car. Half of the price is to pay for the product. And the other half is to pay for the emotion of having it. Fantastic. Fantastic. As a matter of fact, the guys who design this product are the same, as you know. Renova offers you paper in different colors. As a matter of fact, from a functional point of view, it's not so good to have a black paper. But it's much more attractive. It costs 8 times more. You pay for emotion. You pay for decoration. You pay fashion. You see how brands do? What? Bic is a fantastic brand. Use and get rid of it and buy it again. But when they produce silver and gold pens, they are exploring the design and the aesthetic experience. This is also fantastic. Related to Nespresso, they offer cups. And in general, coffee stimulates 2 types of senses, smell and taste. And here we see vision. We see the cream. Let's just imagine that the cup was not transparent. One of the experiences was absolutely lost. That's why it is transparent. The third dimension, vision. And if I see a cup like this, what I want? Have you got an espresso there? I would like to have one just now. But even the functional experience, not only design, can induce an emotional response. This is a old Macintosh, a model of Apple computers produced in the 80s. And they introduced 2 fantastic things. One is the operational system, Windows. Windows today is current, but by that time, the other computers, namely IBM, used MS-DOS. When we have Windows, we say, well, I liked it very much. The letter, everything, we liked it very much. And the mouse, as you may know, the mouse was not created by Apple. It was created by Xerox. But Xerox thought it was not a very interesting invention. And with the mouse, we don't know where our arm finishes and where the computer begins. We are linked with the machine. That's why, in the end, I say, I love this machine. And later, Apple create a thing like this, iPod. In general, these sort of gadgets should be pressed. No, an iPod is not to be pressed. It's just to be caressed. One way, the other way around. And in the end, I would say, I love this product. Of course I love the product. And later, they created the smartphone, the touchscreen, with no anything to press, just to care. So these are, in fact, functional attributes that induce emotional appeals. So if you want, the art of romancing customer, as I would say, the art of romancing people in general. 3 points. Firstly, build, or at least promise, lasting relationships. Well, I don't know if it will last for long, but at least you have to promise that they will last. Secondly, use quality, of course, the function, side by side with the emotion. And thirdly, don't forget that the customer, as each of us, wants to feel special and unique. You remember the way I began my talk, saying that in life everything is persuasion? That's not totally true. In life, everything is seduction. Thank you very much.